Have you ever been in a situation where you regretted spending money on anything? You regretted buying this car, you regretted buying this bag, you regretted buying this house? Well, if you ever told yourself, had I known this, I wouldn't have done that. Well, in this episode, we're going to unlock the wisdom of the daily habits of the richest king who ever lived, starting in 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Never short stopping, now I'm winning like I'm Jeter. Steady through the rigor, yeah, I'm getting bigger. Just fighting in them trenches, now I'm making 7 figures like.
What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy, Matt Sapaula here, hailing to you from Dallas, Texas. And we're here with episode 2 to uncover the hidden secrets of Proverbs chapter 2. And who wrote it? King Solomon, who is regarded as the wisest and wealthiest king who ever lived. But before we get started, if you haven't done so already, please subscribe, because our next goal is to get to 150,000 subs so we can award a church, charity, or nonprofit $5,000 to help them help other people. All right, so let's get into it. I'll just cut to the chase. What is his one daily habit? His one daily habit is every day he was seeking wisdom. Seeking wisdom. What? What are you talking about? It's kind of interesting how people say, well, Matt, I just want the how-tos. Just tell me how to make $1 million. Just tell me how to have a successful business. Just show me how to have 6 figures. Just show me how to become a decamillionaire, etc., etc., etc. But what King Solomon says and what his relationship with God says, listen, don't seek the how-tos. You seek wisdom. Just don't seek knowledge. Seek the acknowledged times experience, because that's simply what is wisdom. Wisdom is broken down to knowledge, means education and understanding, times experience. How many times have you heard somebody interview for a job? I said, well, we like your credentials, we like where you went to school, but we can't hire you. Why? Because you don't have enough experience. In other words, what they're telling you is you don't have enough wisdom. Before I get into the 5 benefits of seeking wisdom, 2 verses stuck out to me, which in my opinion is the overarching theme of Proverbs chapter 2. So let's read it together. Proverbs chapter 2, verse 10 and 11, it reads like this. When wisdom enters your heart and knowledge is pleasant to your soul, discretion will preserve you and understanding will keep you. There's many different decisions that you're gonna have to make on a day-to-day basis. How many times have you plugged into a GPS and it gives you 3 different routes? It gives you the route with tolls, it gives you the street route, it gives you the alternative route. And you gotta pick which one you're going to follow. Well, the same thing here happens with the financial GPS of your life, the wisdom GPS of your life. Are you gonna follow the easier road, the alternative road? Are you gonna follow the road that potentially might lead you to darkness and wickedness? And all these different things we'll talk about here in a second. But every day, you got a choice. And every day, you're free to have a choice, but you are not free of the consequences. So let's unlock real quick the 5 benefits of seeking wisdom. Number one, it gives you protection. It'll give you protection from making bad choices. It'll keep you from bad people that may sound good, may look good, may seem online, see on social media, that they have good intentions. But if you seek wisdom and you tap into this thing called discernment, look, you look into things, not just from the surface level. Because a lot of people today are fooled by what they see online. They're fooled, but they see, you might even be fooled by what you hear from me. That's why I want to encourage you to don't just be in this position where you're asking me to read the Bible for you. I want you to read Proverbs chapter 2. This is just my notes and lessons from it. But when you seek wisdom, you're going to protect yourself from bad decisions, bad people, and bad dealings with your finances. Number two, you're going to find proper choices. Through seeking wisdom, you're going to see the difference between good choices, average choices, optimal choices, bad choices. You're going to be able to see that through the lens of seeking wisdom. Oftentimes people say, well, Matt, you know, I'm a good person. The sad reality of you being a good person is that you think everybody around you are good people. Let me repeat that one more time. The sad reality of you being a good person is that you think that other people around you are also good people. And sadly, the people that you grew up with, sadly, the people you went to school with, sadly, the people you were in the military with, sadly, the people you worked with, you find out who they really are, not in the best of times, but you find out who they really are in the worst of times. Why? Because at that point, many people around you, yourself included, will be making tough choices. So if you affirm with me that you are making better choices in this new year ahead, please put in the comment section below, I am making better choices. I am making better choices. Also in verse 9, making the right choice will lead to profit. There's many times that I've been hasty in my business decisions. My ambition, my desire to climb the success ladder, I mean, a lot of hasty choices. I didn't seek wisdom. I was seeking just opportunity, plain and simple. I was seeking to advance myself, plain and simple. I never looked around the corner and said, you know what, is this the right choice? So you gotta go out there and seek wisdom. And by doing so, you're not gonna lose money. You might profit in making the right proper choices. Also, you will prosper. And number five, you will have peace. When you go off and make a decision and you have wisdom, knowledge, experience behind you, you can then focus on driving forward through the windshield, not always having to look over your shoulder, or driving forward, looking through and looking at the rear view mirror. Consider this, you are on this path. You're on this path to wealth, health, prosperity, and happiness. You ask yourself, I got goals in 2022. It's a new year. I got goals with this new business. I got goals with this new endeavor. I got goals with this new relationship. I got goals with my new credit line. I got goals with my finances. So questions you pose yourself, what do you want? One of the first steps in this path is having absolute clarity about what it is that you want. What is it that you want? What is it that you are seeking and searching for? And sometimes people say, well, I want financial freedom. And I ask them one simple question. Well, great. Awesome. Doesn't everybody else? Here's my question for you. What's the number? What do you mean, what's the number? What's the number you need to make on a monthly basis for you to be financially free? You know what a lot of people say? I don't know. I don't know. Wow, you didn't care to seek wisdom on that? When you're not clear about what you want, it's because you haven't sought wisdom. We just wrapped up 3-4 days with our national team coming here to Dallas to plan, prepare, to seek counsel. Why? Because we're clear about what we want. And as a result, we financially prosper and benefit, and we have peace with our decisions and the tough decisions we have to make along the way here in 2022. Because it leads to the second thing. The second question you ask yourself is, why do you want it? Why do you want financial independence? Lots of times people are unwilling to work for it. And by the way, it's a little harder than you think. However, with that being said, it's also something you can do. If you're able to make a couple adjustments in your life, get clear about what you want, thoughtfully and proactively, get out of your own way and stop living in this nation called procrastination, well, guess what starts happening to you? You understand what you want, why you want it, which leads you to number three. How badly are you willing to get it? Now, in this how badly you're willing to get it, this is where things can get murky. This is where many people probably make hasty decisions, bad decisions that either leads them into debt, that leads them to breaking relationships and burning bridges, which leads them to wasting time. So by tapping into the wisdom of King Solomon here in Proverbs chapter 2, it allows you to have more wisdom in your decisions along the way to wealth, prosperity, and happiness. For example, here are 8 things I wrote down. I took from these 22 verses from Proverbs chapter 2. You were able to receive God's word. God wants you to receive his word, to say, you know, I embrace it, not reject it. He wants you to treasure his commandments. So not only do you receive it, you treasure, you hold on to it. Say, okay, Lord, this is what you want me to do. Because in just not seeking the knowledge, you're also seeking the experience. Because the crazy part about Proverbs, and I'm trying to articulate it in the best way possible, is that God says, don't ask me how, ask for the wisdom of how. Meaning that it's easy to get what you want. It's because after all, making money, it's simply a numbers game. It's simply a numbers game. It's simply a math problem. It's a formula. But along the way, the human nature of us being flawed citizens, of us being flawed in our design. How do we know that? Adam and Eve, the first human being, screwed it up. They were told a command. They were told not to eat a certain fruit from a forbidden tree. And guess what they did? The first human beings ever created screwed it up. And after that, by the way, the funny thing about this whole Bible, you get into the first 3 chapters of mankind. After the first 3 chapters of mankind, boom. Mankind falls. And the rest of the Bible is about how to use wisdom so that we can have a better life from the mistakes of Adam and Eve. A couple of things I also took away from Proverbs is incline your ear. Incline your ear to listen to things. How many ears did God give you? How many one mouth? Here's a challenge today. People want to speak 10 times and listen once. But God gave you 2 ears, one on each side, so therefore you can pay attention with your eyes. Because lots of times communication is just not what you hear, but also what you see. Verbal and nonverbal communication. To my mentor, I want to make sure my mentor knows that I'm inclining my ear to wisdom and understanding their teachings, understanding their mentorship, because then I can apply. When you apply what you learn, guess what you then start getting? You start getting experience. Cry out. Are you just there by yourself? Oh, man, I'm just going to figure this out on my own. The worst place to be as an entrepreneur, the worst place you want to be when you are advancing in something that you desire along this path is to be by yourself in isolation. And guess what? YouTube videos aren't the only thing that allow you to advance. Because I remember we were just in Montana a couple weeks ago. Our good friend Mario was learning on YouTube how to ski. He's like, you know, making these moves. How to ski, how to make a wedges and a pizza with your skis, and et cetera. We've never skied before. Mario's learning on YouTube right before we go out to the slopes. And then we go to the slopes and we realize, goodness gracious, this is harder than we thought it was gonna be. We don't know how to stop. We're just sliding down this hill. We don't know how to stop. We've never skied before. But guess what happens? When you cry out for, coach, help me. How do I turn right? How do I turn left? How do I stop? Guess what happens? Because you can't learn everything just simply on YouTube. You can't learn everything simply by just reading a book. You have to associate with other people who has been there and done that. Also, lift up your voice and ask and seek wisdom as silver. The interesting part, in you're seeking silver, you're seeking wisdom, because the wisdom will get you to silver, will get you to money, will get you to gold. Oftentimes people just say, just tell me what I need to do. Tell me what I need to do. And they think that getting wealthy is just simply an instruction manual, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's intangibles along the way. And those intangibles, when you seek that wisdom, boom, that's when you get wealthy. Boom, that's when you get able to keep the wealth that you're able to create. At the same time here, last but not least, one of my last notes here is searching for wisdom as treasure. Are you seeking wisdom? Are you seeking knowledge like it's the most valuable thing to you? How many times do you take notes and you just kind of throw your notes this way, you throw your notes that way? I've got 10, 15 years of notes once I got to this knowledge, experience, understanding of notes that I've been through. I was just laughing at videos because every time we do Throwback Thursday or Flashback Friday, I laugh every time we do like a January 2005. A January 2008, we look back on what we were doing January 2008 and we laugh because we hear ourselves. We're like, is that us? Have you ever done that yourself? Is that us? Was that me? Man, we've come a long way. Or some of you guys said, man, I haven't come a long way much at all. Why? Because you're isolated. You're putting yourself in a box. And King Solomon says, don't put yourself in that situation. Search for wisdom as you search for treasure, as you search for opportunities, as you search for the instruction manuals and how to get ahead financially. And as you're along this path, there's going to be two directions you're going to follow. The people that are making money in any endeavor, they're the ones that are seeking wisdom. They're seeking guidance. They're seeking advice. And oftentimes people say, well, what's the difference? Well, Matthew, there's one path here. I'm get rich quick. I realize that I want to get rich quick now. Well, the downside to that is, in Proverbs it says, there's no such thing as get rich quick. There's no such thing. Well, you might get rich quick. You make a lot of money in a short period of time, but guess what happens? Because you didn't have the right wisdom and personal leadership and foundation to hold that money, guess what happens to it? Eventually, you lose it. How many times have you heard of millionaires or even athletes 4 or 5 years after their wealth or their career, they're broke? You know why? Because they never fixed this. Because after the league, after they made their millions, they stopped seeking wisdom. They stopped putting the right people around them. They didn't have the right people giving them advice in their ear. One path will lead you to darkness, verse 13. One path will lead you to deviousness and crookedness, verse 15. One path will lead you to seduction and to forsake and forget what you stand for, verse 16 and 17. Well, the path of righteousness will lead you to light. It'll lead you to perseverance. It'll lead you to keep what you've earned. It'll allow you to deliver men, not only yourself, but other people from bad choices and decisions, and make the right decision, put you on the path to life. And if you're firm with me that you're on this path, please affirm with me in the comment section below, because you want to give God all the glory in the situation. I am on the road to wealth, prosperity, and happiness. Praise the Lord. I am on the road to wealth, prosperity, and happiness. Hashtag praise the Lord. So as you're going off into this new year, you got these big, grandiose plans, these New Year's resolutions, which I hope you fulfill. But please, along the way, make sure you seek wisdom. And don't be so stubborn. Oftentimes people have the right answer in front of them, but here's what they fail to do. They get the right knowledge, they get the right information, but they don't want to get experience by going and doing it. My suggestion for many of you this whole coronavirus has caught a lot of people in a mix. You see these countries and see these other cities and states in our country, in the United States of America. You see other countries around the world shutting down vaccine. Listen, regardless of what you think about it, the bottom line is you still got to make money. And so your best bet is to seek wisdom on people that are making money in the midst of this pandemic, not operating in a spirit of fear, but are succeeding, they're elevating, they're compounding, they're going through the situation with confidence and clarity. Why? Because they're not going through it by themselves. And I hope that's the path you take to as well, because one of the worst situations you can find yourself in is a position of isolation, darkness. And by the way, this whole situation of everybody forcing everybody to stay home and not talk and not interact with people, that's a bad thing. Because you are supposed to be around people and to meet and relate and share ideas. That's how the wealthy get wealthy. The rich get rich by having retreats and getting together and sharing the best practices and sharing the knowledge, sharing the relationships. And that's what I hope for you in 2022. That being said, guys, if you affirm with me that you're going to go off this year in 2022, please affirm with me that I am seeking wisdom in the comment section below. I am seeking wisdom in the comment section below. If you affirm with me, that's what you're going to be doing here in 2022. Before I let you go, please check out these two videos right here. Is our video from last week, the five best pieces of advice from the richest king who ever lived. And also my interview, my second interview with Rabbi Daniel Lapin here on wealth, ambition, avoiding greed, all these different things here we discussed in this episode right here. That being said, whatever your thoughts, comments, feedback, you agree with me, you don't agree with me, put it in the comment section below. I love to hear what you're thinking. And if you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page, Money Smart Guy. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click like, hit subscribe, and hit notifications to be alerted the next time we upload our next episode. Thank you for joining us here on this Wealth and Wisdom series, episode 2, as we uncover the secrets of Proverbs chapter 2. That being said, I'm your Money Smart Guy from Dallas, Texas, and until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today. We'll be right back.